Okay, so thank you all for joining us today. It's very much appreciated. There's been a hell of a buzz around the InnoCare offices today. My name is Kelly Smart. I'm the English one, so you don't need to change your volume. I really am that loud. I'm also known as the sales manager here at InnoCare, and it's our job on a daily basis to ensure that we're speaking with clinicians just like yourself and finding solutions that help to make your lives easier. And that's one of the reasons that we've actually started this webinar series. So we're kicking it off today by talking about Charting Plus. Now, we know that you're going to love it. We know that it's going to make your life easier. And we're going to spend the next 10 to 15 minutes explaining to you exactly why. Now, if we've done our jobs correctly, there should be some videos playing alongside us talking. And if we have done our jobs correctly, which I'm sure that we have, the first one should be showing you how to create an account. Now, please go ahead and create an account as soon as possible. We're actually giving away a month free at the moment, so make sure that you take advantage of that. You will also get immediate access to everything that we're showing today, as well as a sneaky little surprise at the end. So make sure that you stay tuned for that. So let's get started. Waleed, would you like to introduce yourself?
Well, thank you very much for having me, Kelly. I really appreciate the opportunity to have some time to talk to you guys about Charting Plus. Like you said, I'm a physiotherapist that's working out in the community. I've had the privilege of working with PT Health for the better part of 10 years, as well as in three different provinces. Right now, I'm working at a clinic in Caledonia, Ontario, and I'm working alongside a massage therapist and an osteopath, both of whom also use Charting Plus.
Okay, so tell me, as I'm not a clinician, obviously, so tell me, what does your average day look like?
Well, my average day involves a lot of patient care, which is the bright point of my day and what gets me out of bed every morning. I love helping patients get better, helping them return back to function and attain all of their goals. The opposite side of that coin, sometimes the dark part of that is the record keeping involved with taking care of all these patients and making sure that we're helping them accurately.
I can only imagine what headache that must be. So what makes Charting Plus different?
Well, what I really like about Charting Plus is the fact that it reduces a lot of the redundancies associated with record keeping. It makes sure that you can collect all of your patient information in one convenient place and communicate it as needed.
Okay, so how does it do all that?
Well, it does that in a variety of different methods. One of the main things that I really like about Charting Plus is that it prompts a clinician to ask patient's question in a sequenced manner, which helps you create an accurate patient picture. It also has some preloaded diagnostic codes, which are used for effective communication there with different regulatory boards and with different clinicians. And most importantly, it saves you time by helping you populate different regulatory forms as well as treatment notes.
Okay, does queuing clinicians really matter? I mean, don't you guys know all that already?
One would think so. Definitely a seasoned clinician would definitely have that ability to do that, having practiced at many different clinics in many different provinces. Okay. I can see how regulations change between the different provinces. You also have regulations that are constantly getting updated as well. So making sure that you have a platform that prompts you to ask all of these questions so that you can create an accurate patient picture is extremely helpful. It also helps there with some of our newer clinicians there. Oftentimes in class, you may not have exposure to ask all of these questions, and having a program that prompts you to do that, as well as giving you some education about some of the reports that you need to produce for these patients, is extremely helpful. So it helps on both ends of the spectrum.
Okay, so you're explaining to me it helps the seasoned clinician, it will also help a new grad. How does it benefit the patient?
Well, that's the most important part, and as a clinician, you want to make sure that you're helping your patient as much as possible. That's what gets us going each day, and making sure that you have a system that allows you to report on that patient in an accurate manner, creating a detailed treatment plan to assist that patient as quickly and accurately as possible is really important. So having both ends of the spectrum, helping the clinician as well as helping the patient is extremely helpful.
Okay, so it sounds really great how it helps the clinician, betters the patient experience. Is there anything else that the queuing helps with?
Well, as I mentioned earlier, aside from prompting you to ask the specific questions, Charting Plus also has some preloaded diagnostic codes. These diagnostic codes are a universal language that we use to communicate patient information, and having that at your fingertips is really a helpful function there in Charting Plus.
What's so special about the diagnostic codes?
Well, the diagnostic codes in Charting Plus are contained in an interactive body man, which you should be seeing in the video playing alongside us. These diagnostic codes are available at your fingertips. You're able to select them on the body man, and depending on the body area, as well as the particular injury that you're treating that patient for.
Okay, so how would you navigate this on Charting Plus?
Well, Charting Plus, with that interactive body man, you have the ability to select up to 5 different injury sites, as well as 5 different injury codes per injury site. So that's up to 25 different injury codes that you can put into your treatment plan for that particular patient without having to look them up. So having them at your fingertips is amazing. In the example of a more complex motor vehicle accident patient, you're able to select all those injury sites and report on that patient to the motor vehicle adjuster as needed.
So where does the information go after that?
Well, once you've created your treatment plan, you have the ability to complete your assessment note. And then once you've completed that assessment note, you should have the ability to create some motor vehicle accident reports that you can submit to that motor vehicle adjuster. You also have the ability to select some workplace injury forms as well. And all of this information is pre-populated on these forms from your clinician note.
Is there anything else that gets pre-populated to help you out there?
Well, aside from the diagnostic forms that we mentioned earlier, you also have your treatment plan in as part of your assessment note. So okay. That's a lot of information that you input into that patient's record, and having that pre-populated onto the next treatment note or the next SOAP note is great. It allows you to keep that at your fingertips. Also, a lot of the objective information or the objective findings that you would put into your assessment note are also populated on that SOAP note. So you have that for easy reference, and you also have the ability to mark down any changes that that patient has during the treatment session.
And how else would this be beneficial for the patient?
Well, we're all part of a circle of care, and completing that circle of care by being able to communicate with a patient's family physician and or any other referring practitioner, such as a patient's surgeon, is great. So being able to create a report of what you're going to be doing with that patient, the different treatments that are going to be involved there with the rehab, is great. And having that ability to create that on demand in a professional format and submit that to the physician or the surgeon is really handy.
Okay, so you mentioned previously about more complex cases, like, for example, motor vehicle accidents. If somebody was to ask for something after the fact, say an adjuster or a lawyer, how would you be able to transfer that information?
Well, Charting Plus has a unique and interactive patient profile where you have the ability to access any of your previous clinician notes for reference, and you're also able to make sure that you're able to download any of the forms that you require at that point in time. Okay. And then you can also print out any of your clinician notes in a professional format, review them, and then submit them to anybody seeking them.
Okay, so can you save it and attach it in an email? Is that a stupid question? I don't know. Can you do that?
Absolutely. That's one of the other handy features that you have in Charting Plus. Any of your notes or reports that you create, you're able to preview them, review them, save them, attach them as part of an email, print them out and send them in the mail, or fax them off.
Any other forms?
I don't know if people still use messenger pigeons, but maybe you can do that as well.
You could send it like that. Okay, it all sounds very intuitive.
Absolutely. That's one of the great parts about Charting Plus as well, is that it's a platform that's been created by clinicians. So it has that information already stored into it. And you also have the ability to submit some feedback using the feedback function in Charting Plus. The video running alongside us should be showing you how to submit that feedback to the developers. And Charting Plus is constantly being updated with clinician and user feedback.
Would you like to elaborate a bit, Waleed?
Well, I was one of the first people to sign up for Charting Plus, and one of the things that I've noticed with other forms of charting that I've used is that, especially in an electronic format, if you're called away to work with a patient or to a different task, you can often lose that information, and that just creates a lot of time-consuming, redundant information that you need to populate. So one feedback that I submitted to the developers was the ability to create an autosave function. So Charting Plus now has the ability to autosave every 60 seconds, so if you're called away or there's power outage or anything like that, your information is going to be stored.
I think you fib in. I don't think that was your idea.
I don't like to brag, but I'm going to have to take it for that one.
Okay, so there should be a video at the moment showing you exactly how to submit that feedback, that feedback does go directly to developers. So just out of interest, Waleed, what advice would you give to somebody that's looking to take the plunge, but they're still charting at the moment the old-fashioned way?
Well, I'm not one for heights, but I would definitely take the jump on this one. Charting Plus is going to be a very unique platform coming up in the future. It's always constantly being evolved, so making sure that you get in on this at the beginning level is really important. As well, electronic medical records are becoming a big part of allied health as well as rehab services in general. So using Charting Plus now will be your new comfort zone in the future.
Okay, so what has it given you?
Well, I have to say that Charting Plus does save me quite a bit of time. Like I mentioned, it reduces a lot of the redundancies and the time-consuming tasks associated with patient care, so I can spend less time writing things down and more time helping my patients get better.
Okay. On average, how much time would you say it saved you a day?
Well, it really depends on the day and the type of reports that you need to produce, but on a busy day at my clinic, it can save me upwards of a couple of hours.
No way. I think you're exaggerating that.
On some of those long days where you're treating patients and you have a lot of reports to produce, the last thing a clinician wants to do is spend time creating these reports with information that they've already recorded. So having the ability to produce those reports can save you upwards of a couple of hours. It's not a lot.
That's amazing. So can you tell us what you're doing with all this free time now?
Well, let's just say my golf clubs haven't left my trap. But more seriously, Charting Plus is a great program. It's always continuously being evolved, and I'm really happy to have started using it.
It sounds too good to be true. Let's see if we've got any questions. We've got questions? Great. Okay, so a question from Paul. Are intake soap forms customizable?
Intake soap forms are semi-customizable depending on the type of information that you're able to or wanting to put into that information. The treatment plan copies over from your assessment note, so making sure that you put in the information that you want, it'll copy forward onto your soap note.
Okay, that's pretty amazing. Another question that I think we had come in was, where is the data stored?
Well, the data is stored right here in our beautiful country of Canada. It's stored securely on a cloud-based platform. I'm not one for technology, but it sounds something that is definitely I've researched, and I'm happy to say that that information is stored properly there without any intrusions.
Okay, that's pretty good. A question from Danielle. I have a Mac. Is it compatible?
Absolutely. That's another key feature there about Charting Plus is that you're able to use it on a variety of different applications. You can use it on your computer, your laptop, tablet. I've even charted on my phone, so.
I bet that was handy. Okay, that's great. So any more questions? They're coming in, everybody. So can you show how a soap note is added, and are there any pre-populated parts once you have started the patient's file?
Well, we actually have some training material associated with the ability to do this. I'll make sure that we touch base there with you directly and send you that information. That way you can see it, and we'll also add it onto the YouTube channel so that other people can view it as well.
Okay, if there are any other questions or something comes to your mind after we've gone offline, please go to the website and check out our frequently asked questions page, and you'll see that there's a lot of diversity there with the questions, and we make sure that we cover most things. If there is something there that's not answered for you, you can send us an email at sales@innocare.ca. Now, Waleed, anything else happening? Anything coming down the line? Anything to get excited about?
Well, there's a lot to be excited about with this constantly changing program, but one of the main things is that you always want to make sure that you continue to engage your patient and make sure that you have good communication there with them. So I'm happy to hear that Charting Plus is partnering with InnoCare Engage, which is a platform that's going to be sending out patient-specific communication. Oftentimes when I'm treating patients, I'm giving them a lot of information, and it's great to have the ability to be able to send that information automatically to them, have them access it as needed and when needed. That way they can have a more robust and interactive experience at our clinic.
That is amazing. And rumors have let me know that this has actually been launched today. So if you actually sign up for charting today, you will actually gain the access to that secret little surprise I told you about at the beginning, marketing tool. So please go ahead and take a look. It's very simple to use. And if you have any questions, again, just shoot us an email at sales@innocare.ca. Also, we are happy to announce that the one and only CEO of InnoCare will be joining us in our next webinar on the 25th of July. The one and only Heather Shantora will be joining us on the 25th of July, just to reiterate, to discuss the Engage email marketing and how it's going to change your lives with your patients. Let us help you engage. Thank you very much.